Calise, and I'm reporting live from WinterNAMM 2020, and I'm here with my good friend Matt from BOSS. How you doing, Matt?
Good. Thank you very much. Good.
Fabulous. Fabulous. Well, we're here to talk about the Katana Artist Mach 2 amp. So tell us a little bit about it.
Yeah. So for those of you who may not be familiar, we released an amp called the Katana about 3 years ago, and it was just hugely successful just because it felt so good. It was so easy to use, and it was great to get a good sound out of it. So from that, we released like a more flagship one, which was the Artist. And then last year, we actually updated the whole range and brought a bunch of new features in. But we left the Artist until WinterNAMM. So now we've got a fully upgraded like performance. We call it like a performance class amplifier. It's like our stage ready go-to amp. But the thing that makes this absolutely killer is the fact that it's got an analog class AV power amp.
Right.
So a lot of other practice amps or amps of this kind of style tend to be class D, and it doesn't really give you the same feel and response as like plugging into other amps that you might be used to, other valve amps and things
right.
like that. So this one is far more realistic, should I say.
Okay.
It's not a term we always use, but so with this now, what we've got is a bunch of really great like performance features for stage use.
Okay.
So we've got like a real kind of stage amplifier. So just a quick run through on what we've got on here. 10 different amp tones. So you've got 5 different amp models, plus a dedicated acoustic preamp, so you can plug an acoustic into it
okay.
as well. Full tone stack, and then you've also got dual concentric controls for effects. So you can have up to 5 effects on at the same time. And then we've also got power control. So this is 100 watts, but you can go down to 0.5 as well. You know, if you want to take a sound from the bedroom that you've dialed in or the studio and then go out and use it live, you can just crank that all the way back up to 100 watts.
Okay.
And we also have like a custom designed speaker. So we build all our own proprietary hardware.
Mm-hmm.
So we redesigned a kind of legendary sort of greenback speaker into a 100 watt speaker instead of like the usual 25 to handle the power in here. And that gives you like real classic sort of British amp tones.
Right, right.
But then we've also got a ton of really cool features for people who want to use it at home and then take it out live. So you've got USB out for editing and
right.
recording. There's a line out. You can extend into bigger cabs and stuff like that as well. So we've kind of thought of everything.
Okay.
But the key thing that we really wanted to do was make sure that it was easy to use.
Right.
How often, you know, you get a bit of equipment, it's like, oh, it's got all this stuff on it, but I have to read the manual, or I have to like
yeah.
spend hours trying to tweak it just to find that one sound.
Right. Well, can you show us how easy it is to operate?
Absolutely. So on the front panel, you can go straight in and then you just pick your amp sound. So we've got the acoustic, clean, crunch, lead, or brown, depending
okay.
on what you want. The brown is like kind of legendary Van Halen-esque high gain.
Okay.
Then our simple tone stack, just like any other amplifier. And then the effects is just simply turning it up.
Okay.
That's all it is. It's just turning up the controls until you find the sweet spot. There's no, you know, a lot of times with amps with effects, you're like diving into menus and
right,
trying to scroll
right.
around to find like different settings. This is literally like you turn it up and go.
So it's very simplistic. Like if
yeah.
you're not, you know, really a techie, it's
exactly.
it's the amp for
you. I think that's why it really stands out. Now, if
right.
you get the optional foot controller,
uh-huh.
this then becomes like your pedal board as well.
Okay, yeah, yeah,
so
yeah.
So you can flick through all the presets, 1 to 4, you hit the effects button at the end, and then that just works. It then comes out like a pedal board.
Okay.
So you can turn your delays on and off, your reverbs on and off, your modulations and everything.
Right.
So again, there's no need to set that up. It just does it automatically.
Right.
But the real thing, I think, to be honest, and the reason that people love these is they just feel great.
Right.
You play it, it just, you know, it doesn't feel like a practice amp. It feels
right.
like something you can go out and perform with, but it also doubles up as a great recording tool and just a home studio tool as well.
Right. So what would you say are the biggest differences between the first Katana Artist and then the Mach 2?
Okay, so the key main features were we added 5 new amps.
Okay.
So we had the acoustic, clean, crunch, lead, and brown.
Uh-huh.
We added a variation for all of those.
Okay.
Now, we didn't want to add 10 amps because you just find yourself endlessly scrolling.
Right.
So we just added a little simple variation button so you can go do it like this one or press it or do it like that one.
Okay.
And then before, you could only have 3 effects on at once on the top panel. We've now added dual concentric control so you can have up to 5. Again, it's just a case of turning it up and away you go. And then we also added a feature that allows you to link 2 together so you can run them in stereo as well.
Oh, okay, perfect. Are you going to play a little bit for us so you can show us how it works? Or?
Yeah, I'm more than happy to try and give a few sounds
okay.
if you want. So I can add in some delay as well. And it's just as simple as turning up the control. And then it goes all the way down to clean. And it's just as easy as just leaning over and changing the control.
It's very versatile.
And then just all the way back to the high gain. And then we can dial in some modulation as well on top of that.